likes for this videos. If we get more than 2,000 likes at this videos, we will upload more patriotic news. Seconds ago, Tom Selleck has had enough of Rosie running her mouth. Nobody saw this coming. It's become commonplace in our society for celebrities to use their influence to spread their ideas on government and politics. Such is the case in this clip from the Rosie O'Donnell Show. In this ludicrous interview, Rosie uses the platform of her interview with Tom Selleck to discuss her stance on gun control. Selleck appeared on the show to discuss his upcoming movie, The Love Letter, but instead was ambushed by Rosie and her Second Amendment viewpoints. His response? Priceless. Tom Selleck's grace and poise is part of what we loved about him as his iconic heartthrob character, Magnum P.I. Although the show ended long ago, his own character prevails. And that high moral character was on display when he appeared on the Rosie O'Donnell Show to discuss his upcoming movie, The Love Letter. However, the interview took a turn when Rosie began pestering Selleck about the commercial he did for the NRA. In true Selleck style, his response was gracious and measured, yet he didn't back down to her badgering. He stood by his decisions, and he explained his feelings in a mature and respectable way. So much so that Rosie was forced to apologize for her own bad behavior in light of his impeccable behavior. Our favorite moment from the interview is at 5:25 when Selleck questions Rosie's logic. Rosie, you also have the freedom of speech, but you're not allowed to scream fire in a crowded movie theater because it threatens the safety of other people. Assault weapons threaten the safety of other people. There's no reason, in my opinion, to have them. You wanna have a hunting rifle? Great. You wanna have a handgun? Tom, do you really think the Second Amendment is in the Constitution to guarantee hunting and target shooting? Do you really think that's what the Founding Fathers meant? Rosie, I think the Second Amendment is in the Constitution so that we can have muskets when the British people come over in 1800. I don't think it's in the Constitution to have assault weapons in the year 2000. As Tom sips his coffee, Rosie asks him if she's wrong. That's when Selleck casually nods his head, and we all know he's right. Here's what viewers of the clip are saying about this exchange. She invited Tom on her show and tried to discredit him. He remained very calm and logical. She only made herself look like an ass. Some people just have class and some people are just trash. When Rosie asked, "Don't the guns bear some responsibility?" Tom should have asked her if the spoon bears the responsibility for her obesity. The gun and the spoon are only tools in the hands of men. What do you think of this? Share your opinion. IT's happening. 100,000 signatures to fire Stephen Colbert. The liberal mainstream media promotes wrong values and wrong people. One such thug is Stephen Colbert. After Trump's CBS interview, Colbert said, "Mr. President, I love your presidency. I call it disgrace the nation," he began. "You're not the POTUS, you're the bloatus. You're the glutton with the button. You're a regular gorge Washington." Colbert went on to make homophobic remarks. Disgusting. Who is this smug liberal? Is he a comedian, a journalist, or what? Whatever he is, this guy should not be allowed in front of a camera. He needs to work on his material. The smug media cannot stand that Trump won the election. They call us names like redneck, racist, and trailer trash. They just don't understand real America. Why would they? They are too busy living in their fancy penthouses and sipping expensive wine. I cannot stand the mainstream media. They hate us hard-working Americans. They don't understand our problems. They do not speak for us. The mainstream media needs to be ignored. We cannot allow them to divide us, or threaten us. They rely on these faulty polls to make decisions. Didn't every poll get the 2016 presidential election wrong? The media thinks they are so smart, but they are so detached from normal Americans. I'd like to see a journalist fix a roof or build a porch. I'd like to see one of these celebrities stare at a paycheck that has been sliced in half by ridiculous taxes. These media thugs don't understand working America. They think everything is easy and that we are the problem. They don't understand how damaging Obamacare has been to our businesses. What do you think of this? Share your opinion. Amazing. After making awful joke about the president, Stephen Colbert gets hit with brutal news. Stephen Colbert is known for being one of the least funny hosts in late night. Things got even worse for him this week when he came under fire for making a joke about President Donald Trump that even many liberals say is going too far. Young Conservatives reported that during his show on Monday night, Colbert told Trump that, "The only thing your mouth is good for is being Vladimir Putin's sea holster." Skip to the 11:45 mark in the video above this story to see Colbert actually say that. Various celebrities immediately began firing back at Colbert on Twitter. Caught. Obama's CIA director just leaked Obama's darkest secret. About Russia. Democrats love putting Barack Obama on some kind of pseudo-religious pedestal like he never did anything wrong. Not anymore. Today Obama's ex-CIA director came out and told the world what the media and memes will not. Michael Morrill, who served as CIA director until 2013, went on CBS This Morning, video at bottom, to discuss John Brennan's testimony to Congress. That's when he said this: "Obama did nothing at all to stop Russian interference in the election." Morrill told his boss, "What struck me is that the U.S. government was concerned enough last summer about Russian interference in the election that they had the CIA director make contact with his Russian counterpart and tell them to stop. So my question is, what did the Obama administration do after that, after they learned that the warning had fallen on deaf ears?" Great question. What the hell did Obama do to stop this alleged unprecedented election interference? It appears they did nothing, Morrill said. "For once I agree with an Obama official. Morrill is right. Obama did nothing about Russia. Now, we need to know why. Did Obama secretly want Hillary to lose? Was he afraid of Putin? Or was there Obama connected to Russia in a far more sinister way? Only Obama and his inner circle know the truth, and they may never reveal it. Still, it's important to get Michael Morrill's message shared to everyone who matters to us. The people deserve answers." Major Democrat exposes plan to overthrow President Trump. This is huge. Representative Dennis Kucinich confesses now to what we like to call the presence of a deep state, which is finding its way towards the target of getting our government under attack from within. Kucinich has appeared on Fox News Hannity on Wednesday to discuss this all once again. Kucinich stated, "You have a politicization of the agencies. That is resulting in leaks from anonymous unknown people, and the intention is to take down a president." He recognized that with the present structure, we as U.S. citizens are all at risk. Kucinich explained, "We have to be asking, what is the motive of these people? Who's putting these leaks out? Why isn't somebody coming forward to make that charge and put their name and their reputation behind it instead of attacking through the media and not substantiating their position?" He addressed the question to both the Fox News host and the audience itself. If you are pleased this is confirmed by a Democrat, no less, share this. IT's happening. With this one question, Thray Gowdy nailed John Brennan and gave Trump the best gift of his life. Liberty writers earlier reported that CIA director John Brennan testified before the House today on whether or not Russia interfered in the 2016 election. Democratic Representative Adam Schiff asked Brennan if his aides pressured the intelligence community to drop the Flynn investigation. The two words that Brennan said next shocked everyone in the room. John Brennan said, "No, sir." Thray Gowdy asked Brennan the following question, and then he asked John Brennan specifically, "Did you have evidence of a connection between the campaign and Russian state actors?" Brennan then responded by saying, "As I said, Mr. Gowdy, I don't do evidence. Poor liberals. They have nothing. The Russian thing that they are spinning is a complete conspiracy." Share this if you think that the Democrats have zero evidence. They are trying to convince people that they do, but they don't. It's up to us to show them, patriots. God bless America. H.